Hi, welcome to class. The topic of the day is discharge instructions. 各位同学好，我们今天要学习的主题是出院说明 discharge instructions. I am the instructor, Cindy Chow.
We'll begin the lesson with the study of words and phrases related to the topic. Then we will learn the dialogue and watch a video on student role play. After that,We'll do Q&A to practice English speaking. And finally, we have some practices to help you review and consolidate your learning.
这个单元总共有十个单字要学。Number one, discharge, discharge. 我们来看一下在字典上它的定义。首先我们来听发音。
Discharge.
这是英国式的发音。
Discharge.
美式发音听起来是一样的。那在动词的意思呢，就是 allow someone to leave somewhere， 就是允许某人离开，或者是允许他出院。我们来看例句 ：Patients were discharged from the hospital because the beds were needed by other people。所以病人呢，可以出院了，因为床呢，别人需要床位。OK， 我们再多看，再往下看好了。Discharge 有另外一个意思，就是我们之前有学过，就是从排出、排放。例如 ，large amounts of dangerous waste are discharged daily by the factory， 有大量的这个危险的废弃物被排放出来 by the factory。然后呢，我们再来看一下它的名词的意思。Discharge 当名词的话呢，我们之前学过的就是，在这里就是。所谓的人体所排放出来的一些脓或者是液体的分泌物，例如 a vagina discharge。好 ，discharge 的解释到此。同学如果对这个字有兴趣的话呢，可以自己在这里在 Google 呢搜寻它的其他用法跟例句。Number two certificate， 我们现在来连线网络。首先我们来听英式的发音
Certificate
美式
Certificate
差不多 Certificate 就是证书或证明 An official document 例如 A birth certificate A marriage certificate A death certificate 那我们在临床上呢就是需要医生的证明 A doctor's certificate 或者也可以说是 A medical certificate Number three, dressing. 这个字呢挺有意思的，因为这个字如果把 ing 去掉 ，dress 就是洋装。那在这个医护的情境呢，就是指包扎伤口的敷料。可是事实上呢，它还有其他的意思。例如呢，它还可以当作我们平常吃沙拉用的这个调味料，例如这个沙拉酱，像千岛酱，还有凯撒酱之类的。在我们本单元里面呢，它指的是就是指这个covering， 就是敷料跟纱布。Number four, aseptic， 经过消毒过的。我们来听一下发音。
Aseptic，
或者是 aseptic， 那就是指这个 medically clean or without infection。有经过消毒的无菌的例如 an aseptic wound an aseptic dressing an aseptic bandage aseptic number five 我们来听一下这个英式发音
iodine
发音有点不太一样哦所以我们基本上我们是 follow US 的发音所以我们再听一遍
Iodine
就是碘 Number six, concentric, 同心的
Concentric
例如说 a concentric pattern, 同心圆的图案那这个字为什么会用在这个单元呢就是它是指你在帮病人涂药的时候你的棉花棒应该用以 concentric 的方式来涂抹不要这样来回的擦拭 use the cotton swab and rub the wound in a concentric way, in a concentric way, not in a back and forth way, 以免感染这样。第七个字 gauze
gauze
gauze 就是纱布，纱布，例如 a piece of sterile gauze 无菌的布 gauze。 第八个字 restriction 限制，限制。那这个字如果把 ion 去掉呢，就是动词 restrict。例如你有没有什么饮食上的限制啊？ Do you have any diet restriction? Number 9, avoid, 避免。我们看一下 avoid 的用法。 Avoid 就是避开，例如 I try to avoid supermarkets on Saturdays. They are always so busy. 还有avoid 呢，如果后面有接动词的时候，基本上呢我们一定要用 ing， 例如 I try to avoid going shopping on Saturdays， 这个 avoid 后面如果有动词，原则上都是要加 ing 的，除非你用名词。好， avoid， 例如要避免感染，感染是名词，所以就不用 ing， avoid infection。 但是如果我们说避免得到感染，这个时候avoid getting infection， 这个时候 getting 就要加 ing 了。最后一个字 pamphlet 小册子，那它的念法呢m 要闭嘴，所以要先pen 那 ph 念辅，所以 pamphlet。 现在呢我们请同学跟着老师跟读一次。 Number 1 discharge。Certificate, dressing, aseptic, iodine, concentric, gauze, restriction, avoid, pamphlet. 在片语的部分呢，我们这边有七个片语。我们首先看第一个片语 healthcare instruction。Healthcare 就是照顾的意思， Healthcare Instruction 就是说明或指示，卫教。 Number 2 Cotton swab 我们来看一下 Cotton swab 长什么样子。好，这个就是 Cotton swab 因为是棉花做的 Cotton swab。 Number 3 Back and forth 就是来回。刚刚我有提到，就是在擦药的时候呢，避免来回的擦拭，因为这样会可能会 cause infection。 Number 4 Stay away from 远离，例如我们要远离坏朋友， Stay away from bad friends， 或者 是远离油腻的食物， Stay away from oily food。第五个 an urgent situation， urgent 就是紧急的，急迫的， urgent 紧急的，急迫的。例如 he's going to sign that paper， will you tell him it's urgent？ The most urgent thing in the fire is to make sure everybody is out of the building。 在火灾的时候最紧急的事就是要 确定每个人都有离开建筑物， urgent。Situation 情况，处境情况或形式。例如 her news put me in a difficult situation， 她的消息让我陷入困境。第六个 OPD 呢是 outpatient department 的缩写。那 outpatient 是什么呢？ outpatient 就是门诊病人。
Outpatient
门诊病人，那它的相反就是 Inpatient 住院的病人， Outpatient 所以这个门诊部呢叫 OPD， 那住院部就是 IPD， Inpatient Department。 最后一个 ER 就是 Emergency Room。 Emergency 呢就是 紧急的情况， 或者是突发的状况，例如 How would disabled people escape in an emergency? 那第二个例句 Is the emergency exit suitable for wheelchairs? 这个紧急的出口是不是适合给轮椅呢？现在请同学跟着老师念一次片语 Healthcare instruction Healthcare instruction Pattern swap Pattern swap Back and forth Back and forth Stay away from Stay away from An urgent situation An urgent situation OPD Outpatient department IPD Inpatient department ER Emergency room Emergency room接下来我们来看对话的内容。The patient is ready for discharge, and the nurse gives him some healthcare instructions. Patient is ready for discharge, 已经准备好可以住院了，所以这个护理师呢，在给他做一些说明。我们先来听对话录音。
Discharge instructions.The patient is ready for discharge, and the nurse gives him some health care instructions.
Good morning, Mr. Yang. Did you sleep well last night?
Yes, I did.
You'll be discharged today. Do you need doctor's certificates?
Yes, we need 3 medical certificates for the insurance.
Okay, we will prepare them for you. Let me check your wound. Your wound is healing very well.But there is still some discharge on the suture side.
Do I have to change the dressing for him after we get home?
There's no need to change the dressing unless there's discharge. But you have to check the incision every day. If there is redness, swelling, heat, or pain, it's better to come back and see a doctor.
Yes, I see. How do I change the dressing for him?
Clean the wound with aseptic cotton swab and iodine in a concentric blade, inside out. Remember not to rub the swab back and forth on the wound. Finally, cover the wound with clean gauze.
I got it. Are there any restrictions on his diet?
He needs to stay away from high fat food and avoid eating too much at a time.
Can he exercise after the operation?
He doesn't need to limit his daily activities, just do things normally. After you go home, remember to take medicine regularly. This pamphlet explains what you should do about your medication, diet, and home care. Please read them carefully and follow the instructions.
Okay, I will do it.
Could you tell me what I can do if he has an urgent situation?
If anything happens,such as a fever or severe pain. Please come back to see the doctor immediately at the OPD during the day, or go to the ER during the night.
Thanks for your explanation.
Thank you for taking care of me.
You're welcome. Take care.
现在我们来仔细地看对话的内容。这边呢有三个角色 Nurse, patient, and family.首先护理师说 Good morning Mr. Yang Did you sleep well last night? 他先问候病人杨先生然后问他晚上有没有睡好那病人呢就点头 nod 点头回答 Yes I did 因为是用 did 过去式问所以回答的时候也是用过去式 I did 助动词 did 来回答 You will be discharged today你今天就可以出院那请同学注意一下出院的话基本上 discharge 这个字呢我们都会用 be 动词加上 PP 的形态 出现因为它也算是一个被动的语态因为被允许出院所以呢同学要讲出院的话就是 be 动词加 discharged 例如说我什么时候可以出院呢When can I be discharged? When can I be discharged? OK, 然后接下来呢护理师又问、Do you need doctor's certificates? 需要医师的诊断证明吗这个时候家属回答 Yes, we need 3 medical certificates for insurance、是的他们需要三份这个诊断证明还有诊断证明呢 我们可以说 Doctor Certificate， 也可以说 Medical Certificate， 这两个基本上是可以互换的。那 Insurance 保险、因为可以理赔。 OK， We will prepare them for you。 好的，所以护理师说会帮这个病人准备。接着护理师就来检查这个病人的伤口，他说 Let me check your wound. Your wound is healing very well. 你的伤口呢愈合得非常好。 Your wound is healing very well. But there is still some discharge on the suture side. But there is 就是有，仍然有， there is still 仍然有一些分泌物在这个 suture side 缝合的地方。这时病人的家属就问，Do I have to change the dressing for him after we get home? 回家之后需不需要帮他换这个敷料 change the dressing? There is no need to change the dressing unless there is discharge. 所以到底要不要比较要不要换呢？其实这是要看情况的。如果这边的意思是说 there is no need 是没有必要换 dressing。Unless 除非 ，unless 是除非的意思，除非它是一个连接词，除非有分泌物，要不然是不用换。那意思就是，如果有分泌物 ，if there is discharge， 然后你就要帮它换。Then you need to change the dressing if there is discharge。接下来 ，but you have to check the incision every day。如果说没有 discharge 了。可是还是要每天检查这个切口的地方，check the incision every day， 看看说 if there is redness, swelling, heat or pain, it's better to come back and see the doctor。 如果这个 incision 的地方有红的地方，或者是肿起来，也就是所谓的红肿，还有发热或者是痛，那 it's better 最好是回来医院看医师。好，到现在呢，老师就根据这个部分的对话内容问同学几个问题。好，请问第一个问题 ，Did the patient sleep well last night? Yes, he did. When will the patient be discharged? When will the patient be discharged? 答案是 ，The patient will be discharged today. 好，请接下来问，How many doctor certificates?Does the patient need? 我们的答案是 The patient needs 3 medical certificates. 好，然后再问同学 How is the patient's wound? How is the patient's wound? OK, 的答案就是 His wound is healing very well, but there is still some discharge. 最后一个问题好了。Does the patient have to change the dressing? Does the patient have to change the dressing after he gets home? 病人回家之后，他需要换敷料吗？那同学的回答就是 ，Okay, he doesn't need to. 他不需要。He doesn't need to unless 除非 there is discharge. 接下去我们看下一段。Yes, I see. How do I change the dressing for him?那病人的家属想要知道怎么换这个敷料，怎么帮这个 change the dressing. Clean the wound with aseptic cotton swabs and iodine in a concentric way, inside out. 这个部分属于清洁的部分，清洁伤口 with 用什么呢？用这个 aseptic cotton swabs， 这个无菌的棉花棒以及碘酒。然后呢 ，in a concentric way， 就是清洁的时候是用同心圆的方式这样绕。Inside out 就是从里面开始绕到外面。Inside out 从内圈一直绕到外圈。Remember not to rub the swab back and forth on the wound。啊，记得千万不要 rub 就擦拭哈，就是你那个棉花棒在擦拭的时候，不要 rub back and forth。要来回的擦拭，在伤口的地方这样来回的擦拭，因为这样子可能会引起 infection。Finally， 最后呢 ，cover the wound with clean cloth。最后呢，就是要把它盖起来 ，cover with 用干净的纱布把它盖起来。I got it， Are there any restrictions on his diet?
I got it. 我懂了。
Are there 就是有没有有没有的疑问句。Are there 有没有任何的 restrictions 限制 on his diet 就是在他的饮食方面。He needs to stay away from 就是远离 high fat food 高脂的食物 and avoid eating too much at a time 然后避免一次吃太多。那 avoid 避免的后面动词呢，如果接动词我们基本上都要用动名词，所以 avoid eating。 还有 can he exercise after the operation 那可以运动吗？ He doesn't need to limit his daily activities just do things normally。病人回家呢是不需要限制 limit 是限制哈，每天的活动 limit 限制。我们刚刚有一个限制叫 restriction， 所以我们这个 restriction 的动词呢就是 restrict， 所以这边如果我们要把它代换成 restrict 也是可以的，也就是这个字到 t 为止 restrict。He doesn't need to restrict his daily activities 日常活动。只要正常的做事情就可以。好，那这个部分呢老师也问同学一两个问题好了。来，请问同学How should the patient change the dressing? 请问病人要怎么样来换敷料呢？ How should he change the dressing? 那同学的答案要怎么回答？好，同学可以回答说The patient should clean his woundwith aseptic cotton swabs and iodine in a concentric way inside out. And after cleaning, he should cover the wound with clean gauze. 再来，再问同学哦。What should the patient pay attention to about his diet? What should the patient pay attention to about his diet? 病人要注意什么 ？Pay attention to， 就是关于他的 about his diet， 关于他的饮食，他要注意什么呢？那我们的答案就是 ，the patient is to stay away from high fat food and avoid eating too much at a time。最后一个问题 ，Can the patient exercise after the operation， 或是 after he gets home？ 答案是 ，Yes， he can， 他可以的。Yes， he can do exercise。He doesn't need to limit his daily activities. 接下来护理师 turns to the patient, 转向病人说 After you go home, remember to take medicine regularly. 回家之后呢，记得要按时吃药 regularly, 规律的，定时的。This pamphlet explains what you should do about your medication, diet, and home care. 那这些手册呢，这些Pamphlet 手册里面有解释 What you should do about your medication, diet, and home care. Please read them carefully and follow the instructions. 要仔细的读，然后要按遵照指示 follow the instructions. Okay, I will do it. Could you tell me what I can do if he has an urgent situation? 病人的家属呢，想要知道如果病人发生了 urgent situation 紧急的情况，那可以该怎么办呢？那护理师回答 If anything happens such as a fever or severe pain, please come back to see the doctor immediately at the OPD during the day or go to the ER during the night. 如果有任何事情发生，例如像 fever 或者是严重的痛 severe pain 和剧痛，那就请立刻回来看医师。During the day 白天的时候呢，就到 OPD， 就是到门诊部。那 during the night 晚上的时候就 go to the ER 去急诊室。Thanks for your explanation， 谢谢你的解释。Explanation 解释的动词是 explain，E-X-P-L-A-I-N。Explain. So can you explain this for me? 你可以帮我解释这个吗？ Explain. 那名词的念法请注意是 explanation. 它的字尾是 nation. Nation 的意思就是国家咯。所以 explanation. Explanation. Thank you for taking care of me. 病人呢也谢谢护理师taking care of me, 照顾他。You're welcome, take care. 最后呢护理师请病人要 take care, 保重。这个部分呢老师也来问同学几个问题哦。请问 What kind of information is given in the pamphlet? What type of information is included in the pamphlet? 手册里面有些什么资讯呢？那答案就是The pamphlets include information about medication, diet and home care. 好，下一个问题哦。What can a patient do if he has an urgent situation? What can a patient do if he has an urgent situation? 好，那答案是 He should go back to see the doctor immediately. 我们只要回答到这里就可以了。后面这个 OPD 啊或是 ER 呢我们可以跳过去，就是如果紧急情况就是立刻回去看医生就对了啊，就是 go to the doctor immediately。 download 的讲解到此，我要请同学呢回到对话最开始的地方，从头到尾念一次，看看自己的流利度还有是不是能够很正确的很顺的把它念完。现在我们来看由同学所录制的这段对话的影片。
Good morning, Miss Wang. Did you sleep well last night?
Yes, I did.
You are in charge today. Do you need doctor's certificate?
Yes, we need this medical certificate for exam.
Okay, we will prepare them for you.Let me check your wonder. Your wonder is healing very well, but there is still some discharge on the central seat.
Do I have changed the dressing from after we got home?
There's no need to check the dressing. There's no discharge, but you have to check the indication every day. If there is rainy, well held or pain, it's better to come back and see the doctor.
Yes, I see. How do I change the dressing from
here? Clean the water with the aspirin concentrate swab and the iodine in a concentrate well inside out. Remember not to look the swab back and the fast on the water. Barely cover the water with clean water.
I got it. Are there any restrictions on his diet?
He needs to stay well from high fever and avoid eating too much at a time. As you go home, remember to take a medicine. Because this report is telling what you should do about your medication.And home care, police treat, then care for, and follow the instructions.
I'll do it.
Could you tell me what can I do if he
if
any problem, such as a police conflict to see the doctor.
看完影片之后呢，要来请同学回答几个问题，请同学根据刚刚的对话内容，然后及时的用英文口语的方式来回答这每一个问题。现在我们就来模拟看看，老师现在做考官，老师问完之后同学就要立刻回答哦。好，第一题， Why does a patient need a medical certificate? Because he what? Because he needs them for insurance purposes. He needs them for insurance 也可以 purposes 可以不用讲。Purposes 目的就是他需要诊断书是为了保险。Number two, how is the patient's wound? 同学还记得内容吗？他的伤口恢复得很好，但是呢，在缝合的地方还有点分泌物，对不对？所以这个怎么回答呢？ His wound is healing well, only with some discharge on the suture side. On the suture side. 好，这边被挡住了，这里有一个字，只有一点点的一些分泌物 on the suture side. 第三题， What kind of food should the patient stay away from?他应该远离高油脂的食物，对不对？所以我们答案就是 He should stay away from high fat food. 希望同学都能够很快的而且很流利的来答出这个问题。好，第四， What information is given in the pamphlet? 好，答是什么样的资讯呢？就是关于用药啊，对不对？还有这个 home care 啊，还有这个 diet 饮食的问题，所以 the pamphlet has information about what the patient should do about his education, diet, and home care. 当然，这个答案有点长，其实我们可以让它简化一点。我们现在来看一下怎么让它简化呢？就是我们可以说这边通通不用，看到 the pamphlet has information about.这个也不要了，好，关于用药的资讯，还有 diet 还有 home care 的资讯，所以后面这个部分其实都可以省略掉哦。接下来最后一题， What should the patient do if he has an urgent situation? 我们答案就是紧急的时候就是立刻回医院看医师，所以 he should go back to the hospital to see the doctor.He should come back, or he should go back to see the doctor at the OPD during the day or go to the ER during the night. 好，这是一个非常完整的回答。但是我们也可以改成 He should go back to see the doctor. 这边通通不要了，把它简化一点。然后这边呢改成立刻，就是立刻回院找医师就对了。He should go back to see the doctor immediately. 老师把这个 immediately 写完哦 ,I-M-M-E-D. 如果同学可以的话可以帮助老师拼出来。接下来是 I-A-T-E, immediate. 还有 L-Y, 用副词的方式。好，我们的问答到此。最后我们来做一些练习来加强本单元的学习。第一个练习是是非题 True or False， 请同学根据对话的内容来回答，现在老师问你们就立刻回答 True or False。 好， Number one, The patient will be discharged today. It is true. Number two, The patient needs medical certificates for the insurance. This is true. The patient should check his incision regularly. This is true tooNumber four, there is no restriction on the patient's diet. This is not true. 所以就是 false. 还要 stay away from high fat food. 而且还要 avoid eating too much at a time. 最后 the patient had better not exercise after he goes home. This is not true. 这是 false. This is false.At the better 是最好，他最好不要运动啊，没有，他还是要正常的运动，他不用限制他的活动。He doesn't need to limit his daily activities. 第二个练习是配合题，请把左边的英文跟右边的中文配合。我们看 number one dressing 就是 OK. Number two pamphlet is.Number three, certificate. The answer is true. Aseptic. And last one, iodine. 好，同学有没有全部 bingo? 最后我们来看填空翻译题。 请同学花大约五分钟的时间来根据中文思考空格里面应该填入哪什么样的字。好，假设现在同学都已经完成了，老师来给同学答案。来，第一题就是用无菌棉，所以这里我们需要一个无菌 OK， 棉花棒在这里，好，已经有了。好，然后还有沾优点的药水，这里所以这边需要那个碘，优点，好，碘水，以一种环形的方式，环形的方式。好，所以我们第一个无菌的就是 aseptic， 再来碘水就是 iodide， 还有环形就是 concentric。Number two， 记得棉花棒不要来回擦拭哈。Remember not to 这个擦拭，我们这里需要一个动词，所以擦拭。然后来回叫 back and， 好，我们看答案好了。Rub 擦拭 ，Remember not to rub the swab back and forth。第三，它必须远离。好，远离呢就是片语，就是 stay away from， 对不对 ？Stay away from。然后还有避免吃太多，这个吃太多已经有了，所以这里需要避免，避免就是 avoid。Number four， 请依照指示做，所以我们需要的是动词，就是依照 follow。我们的练习到此结束 ，finished。最后我们来做一个总结 ，In today's lesson, you have learned important words.Used for helping a patient prepare for discharge. 在这一课里面，同学学到一些重要的单字，可以用来协助病人准备出院。还有 ，How to carry our conversation with a foreign patient who is getting out of the hospital， 以及和一位即将离院的外籍病患进行英文的对话。Remember to practice a dialogue with a friend to help you feel confident when you next prepare a patient for discharge. 然后记得要找一个朋友练习这段对话，这样下一次呢，当你协助病患出院的时候，你就会觉得很有信心哦。
This is the end of the lesson. Thanks for joining us. This online course is funded by the Ministry of Education.